Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for coming out to support one of the, well, you know, really the best, most accomplished student musician I've ever had. And honestly, he kicks the rear ends of several of my college friends too. Please welcome Quentin Callewaert.
Watson number called Deep River Blues. And I'd like to continue now with Ray Charles' piece called Hallelujah, I Love Her So.
Nice.
Mm-hmm.
She is my baby and she lives next door. Every morning before the sun comes up, she brings me coffee in my favorite cup. That's why I know, yes I know, hallelujah, I just love her so. When I'm in trouble and I have no friend, I know she'll go with me to the end. Everybody asks me how I know, I smile at them and say she told me so. That's why I know, yes I know, hallelujah, I just love her so. And if I call her on the telephone and tell her that I'm all alone now, by the time I count from 1 to 4, I hear her on my door. In the evening when the sun goes down and there is nobody else around, she kisses me and she holds me tight and tells me everything's alright. That's why I know, yes I know, hallelujah, I just love her so. Take it, boy.
Tennessee for the very first time this January, I think, with my parents. We were visiting a few colleges down there, and for me, as a musician, it was pretty inspiring to be down there where really all the greats had, that was really their stomping ground, and just kind of walking around the streets and hearing live music and all the stories of old, I guess. It was very inspiring for me. I think one of the highlights of the trip was we visited the historic Ryman Auditorium where they used to host the Grand Ole Opry. We were going through the tour guide and at a part of it there, they show you kind of a stairwell that leads up to the stage. And at the bottom of the stairwell, there's a little door that heads out into the alley. And about 100 yards from the edge of the door is the door to a pub that all the musicians used to kind of sneak out before their time to play and, you know, do what musicians do best and then come back and play their show. So it was said that when Johnny Cash would play at the Opry, it would take him 20 steps to get from the door of the Opry to the pub and about 100 dizzy, drunken steps to get back when he was finished. As a musician, of course, as a human, I think I love hearing that. So don't be afraid. hope you enjoy this next tune. It's written by Johnny Cash. I hope you enjoy it. Play a few tunes from the album itself. The album for me is especially important because it's the first time I've really displayed any of my own songwriting and not just kind of hid it under the bed like you know, on my previous ones. And this is one of the first tunes that kind of broadened the spectrum from just doing a few recorded tracks to doing a full album. I wrote this about a year ago as one of the first tunes, and I must admit at the time I wasn't feeling very creative in the lyric department, and so I kept it just to an instrumental. And for a while, I didn't really have a name for this tune, although I knew that it was in D major, and I knew that it was an original, so I was just calling it D major original, which made an awful lot of sense at the time. But after thinking about it for several months, I thought it ought to have a better name on the back of the record. What's up, man?
What's up? You doing,
man? Tandy Pescatore right there. Yeah. Where were we? Right. It was called D Major, and I thought it ought to have a better name for the back of the album, at least if people looked at it. So I stole a name from Frederick Handel, and I hope he doesn't mind. Told me he couldn't be here tonight anyway, so I don't think he would particularly mind. So I hope you enjoy. It's called Water Music in D Major.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Acoustic guitarists at the time, so say Doc Watson, Jerry Reed, Merle Travis, all those who kind of pioneered the finger picking genre. And so I hope you enjoy. This one's called Boston Rag. And the tune is particularly good because you can kind of morph it to wherever you're playing, and it's always a crowd pleaser. For example, tonight it can be called Byfield Rag. Tomorrow could be New York Rag. It gets a little complicated when you get to 3 and 4 syllable. Where the Saratoga Springs were active. Not the same kind of ring set. It works tonight. Hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. I suppose I should actually play one of my originals that has words in it. This was actually the last track that was recorded on the album. It was also the last one I wrote, and it was the only track where I actually performed the music live, which means I had a microphone for my voice. Hey Ben, that's Benorama right there. How you doing? Thanks for now learning the song for us tonight. Seemed to have a little bit of difficulty, but that's all right. Make acoustic guitar so you can hear it without all the speakers, you know? But this was the only tune that was a live performance, just guitar and vocal mic at the same time. And for me, it kind of has a special spot on the record. It kind of sounds a little bit different from the other ones. So I hope you enjoy it. It's called Sail Away. Tell her, but the words catch on my tongue. But she has a way of knowing. She knows I don't need no one. When I need her, I need her right now. You know I do. You know I do. I love her right now, you know it's true. So when the rain falls down on me like a child, I get to run. But she always makes me come in from the storm. I don't know why I can feel so shy when I try my best to tell her. But for the world I would not hurt. When she smiles, I know everything's alright, and I'll be sailing away tonight. I feel her every minute now, even when she's not around. Keeps my heart beating now. She keeps my feet right on the ground. When I need her right now. You know I do. You know I do. to think that growing up, my parents really exposed me to a lot of really phenomenal music. And I think that's really kind of shaped both the way I play and the way I kind of just think about music in general. They had me listening to some really great bands like Steely Dan and Queen and Fleetwood Mac and all those phenomenal bands that they grew up listening to. And some of my earliest childhood memories are of sitting in front of the stereo and just my dad playing through pretty much every single Beatles song and every single Beatles record. And I love it just because I love the music, but when I started playing guitar and touring, it also gave me the added benefit that I knew a catalog of about 300 songs and I knew all the words already. So I'd like to play now a medley of some of my favorite Beatles pieces. Granted, these aren't really like you'd hear on the records, but they're more kind of adapted for the acoustic guitar, so I hope you enjoy.
Martha, my dear, though I spend my days in conversation, please remember me. Martha, my love, don't forget me. Martha, my dear, hold your head out, you silly girl. Look what you've done when you thank you. get back home. Once there was a way to get back home. Sleep pretty, darling, do not cry. And I will sing a lullaby. Golden slumbers fill your eyes. Smiles awake you when you rise. Stay pretty, darling, do not cry. And I will sing a lullaby. Once goes away. Get back home. Once there was a way to get back home. Stay pretty, darling, do not cry. I will sing a lullaby.
Thank you very much.
I'm going to do one more tune and then we're going to take a very short break. And in case you thought all this stuff behind me was just for the, or just props really, you'd be wrong, because after the break I'll be joined by some very good friends of mine and some fine musicians, so I hope you stick around for that. It's going to be a blast. And I do encourage you to go out, get something to eat, get something to drink, buy a CD, buy a t-shirt. That is how I'm getting paid, so.
How much are t-shirts?
T-shirts are $20. You can wear them around school, you can wear them wherever you want. When people ask you who's on your shirt, you can give them a CD and I'm listening to it. This last bit is written by the great Mason Williams and is, well, probably the song I've been playing in sets for the very longest. So I hope you enjoy it. Thank you very much. Welcome back. Good to see so many of you have decided to join us for part two. You may notice that it sounds quite a bit different than the first act did. I want to say what a pleasure it is to be on the stage with these fine young gentlemen tonight. You'll begin to know them as the night goes on, but that first tune was one of mine off the album. It's called That's Where I Want to Stay. I'd like to continue now with another Beatles tune. We were talking about Beatles a lot during the first set, but we'd like to play one off of with the Beatles. It's called You Really Got a Hold on Me. Ben, you get any signal on this guitar here? Don't come step. Oh, yeah. quite remember who wrote the tune, but Creedence Clearwater Revival made this one famous in the 60s. It's one of my all-time favorites as well, so hope you enjoy this one. It's called I Put a Spell on You. Yesterday, Nathaniel had a tennis match, and I had a track meet, and they were about 100 meters apart. And I'm finishing up my race, and I hear people talking about the tennis match. And they say that one of the kids there had seriously messed up their leg. And I was like, oh, that's bad. And then I caught wind, and it was this fellow Nathaniel. And I said, oh, that's bad. I'm very happy that he's here tonight, and I'm sure you are all too. He's a fabulous guy. He's only a sophomore as well, which is just we're very, very happy. One you won't hear on the album. This is a newer one. You might actually be the first audience to ever hear it.
Come back to me.
first gone to the whole project of the album, it really didn't start that clearly. I got a call from John Butcher, from the John Butcher Access. And he had seen me kind of around and had been interested in doing a project together. And so he invited me into the studio to record two tunes, one of which was Deep River Blues, and the second one, which was this one, which is actually the first original recorded for the album. And we spent a day in the studio just kind of going through and tracking them. And we loved working with each other so much that we just decided to make a whole album of it. I always really liked this tune because it's kind of what started it all, I guess. Although I suppose when I first wrote it, I thought it was utter crap, like I do with pretty much everything I write. But I hope you enjoy this one. It's called Feels Like Rain Again.
Oh.
did not have enough room yet. In this peculiar arrangement, we'd like to play for you an old folk standard. Hope you enjoy. Start this next number. You may notice that the guitar that Toogies is holding on my left here looks quite unique, and that's because he built that thing. Put it under the lights. Isn't that a beauty? Toogies here, a phenomenal guitar player, by the way. He's also a very handy luthier, which is something we all need. Suffice to say, if you would like a guitar, his merch table just happens to be a little more expensive than mine. another one of mine, another one you won't be hearing on the album, but maybe in an album later. So another one that I don't believe any audience has heard until tonight. And we're very excited about it. I think this might be your favorite. I'm sure it'll come as no surprise that I wrote this song shortly after listening to The Police.
Well, you keep on knocking, but you'll never get to talking to me. Cause my mind is understanding, but my heart is begging you to leave. You keep on knocking, but you'll never get to talking to me.
By Coach Mack. I used to call you Hot Pockets. I don't know why.
I just talked about Hot Pockets.
Yeah.
Kind of very. It used to be my PlayStation name.
Yeah. I didn't think they meant at the time, although I don't particularly see the resemblance now. Maybe then, I don't know, maybe you did look like Hot Pockets. I'm very happy. He graduated from Triton last year, so it's been a little while since we've played on the same stage together, but it feels good to be back. Aww. Thank you.
know it sounds funny, but I just can't stand the pain. Girl, I'm leaving you tomorrow. Seems to me, girl, you know I've got all I can. See, I beg, stole, and I borrowed. That's why I'm easy. I'm easy like some morning, yeah. That's why I'm easy. I'm easy like some morning. Why in the world anybody put chains on me? I paid my dues to make it. Everybody wants me to be what they want me to be. I'm not happy when I try to fake it. Oh no, no. Why easy? Easy like some fool, yeah. That's why I'm easy. I'm easy like some fool. I wanna be high, so high. I wanna be.
Firstly, you saw from him earlier, Mr. Ben Aramo running sound for us all night. Up there working is Mr. Andrew Pesatoro. Thank you to Robert Lathrop and his VTV crew for filming everything here. You're doing a great job. And of course, perhaps most importantly, thank you to Sue Densmore for allowing this whole thing to go on and for suggesting in the first place that we do this thing. It's really thanks to you that we get to be up here tonight. Otherwise, we'd have to do it out in the street, which is considerably less fun. And of course, course, I'd like to just thank my wonderful bandmates up here. It's been an absolute pleasure. These guys got together. This is actually our first time playing as a band together on stage. We've got together maybe four times before this, and I just gave them the music, and they learned it, and they came and did a great job as far as I'm concerned. So, this is our last tune, but if you make sure to cheer extra loudly, we'll be coming out for one more. But. Thank you. thank you so much for coming out tonight. It's really been a pleasure. I know it's a dream come true for me at least to finally have an album out. Feels good. Oh, and if you're around next week, actually, 3 Blocks East is going to be here Friday night, I think, right?
Yeah.
Oh, my. This guy might be playing. Just love it. And we'll be out and about around in the, I guess, not really the lobby, it's really a hallway. But we'll be there afterward and come say hello. I'm sure I know many of you already. Anyways, I'll say hello. It's been a pleasure. Thank you very much.